prophet like Jonah could give a mere confession of his sin and provoke a response like this in these sinful mariners, imagine how much God could use him to do if he would get right with God and go to the people that God has sent him to with the message God has given him to give. What kind of a revival could God send then? It kind of looks like God's beginning to show him something, doesn't it? They say, "Why hast thou done this?" For they knew that he had fled from the presence of the Lord. They were appalled that knowing God and even receiving revelations from him, this man would try to flee from him and flee to their very boat, putting them all in danger of the backslider's curse. You know, any time that the world sees a child of God doing something wrong, the question comes immediately off their lips, "Why hast thou done this?" The world has a great way of holding Christians' feet to the fire, of holding us up to a higher standard, don't they? They're quick to point out when we do wrong. They're good about holding us to a higher standard. And you know what? They should be. When we tell them that Christ has changed our lives, we have tacitly invited them to look at our lives and see if they do not see a transformation, something that God, they might want God to do in their lives. We invite them to do that. Our lives are supposed to be a testimony of the difference that Christ makes in anyone's life. And when our lives are not, the world is very quick to catch it. All Christians are pictures of Christ. That's why we're called Christians. The only question is, are we going to be a good picture or a bad one? One Christian can do more damage to the cause of Christ than a boatload of sinners.